wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder working power in the precious blood. Holy Spirit, fire, fill my spirit, fill my soul, fill my life. Holy Spirit, fire, fill my spirit, fill my soul, fill my life. In the name of Jesus, fill my spirit, fill my soul, fill my life. Hi, YouTube viewers, it's Tina TV for you again today. And today I just want to talk a little bit about angels, how we can release the angels of God to do assignments on our behalf. Me, for instance, I love praying a lot and I like using the scriptures, speaking in tongues, praying the blood of Jesus. But I realize I haven't been using angels too much. And the Lord has been laying on my spirit the importance, because the angels can do a lot for us too. And actually, when we proclaim the word of God, there's always also angelic manifestation. But for you to also just voice out for the angels to do the job of God is very good, because then you activate the angels. There are millions of angels, or maybe much more than our human mind can understand. So the angels are there to serve me and you. And don't forget, when God created the angels, they were all holy angels. But when some of them rebelled, as we can see, then we had Satan, and then there are many other wicked angels who have been chained. You know, and God created hell for the angels. Actually, he didn't create hell for human beings, but he created hell that he will put the angels that rebelled in there on the last day. But if me and you disobey him and we keep rejecting Jesus Christ, then we can also find our place in hell, which doesn't favor us at all as human beings, because the substance of which our body was made, Jesus didn't think hell wasn't for us. Okay, so now what are the activities of angels? And what are angels made of? We know angels were not created out of sand like we are. Some of them were created out of wind and many other different substances than we were. That is one thing we might talk about another time. So angels can do many mighty things. Because we have fallen, there are many things we are restricted and limited to. But when you look at the angels, because they are spirit beings, there are many things that they know in advance of us. But angels are not glorified bodies, because when Christ shall rule, we will be ruling the angels. Even in this modern day presence under the curse, because of the power of the blood, we still have authority. Because when we command, the angels go and do. And we also even have power in the blood of Jesus to silence angelic activity. So today I just want to scratch in a very short summary what angels are. So angels were created by God, even both the evil ones, because they were good angels before they became evil angels. So what are the activities of angels? Angels can protect, angels can accompany, they guide, they can strengthen, they can empower, they can encourage. Angels also intervene in the affairs of the nations. So angels can rule us. As we live on earth, whether we like it or not, we go through many influences. The negative voices, the good voices, the negative angels, they are all angelic influences. So I want us to use Ephesians chapter 6 verse 10 to 12 as a baseline of our scriptures. So child of God, if you haven't been invoking angelic activities, you have to learn to do that. Because the evil powers, or those who worship Satan, or those who are into idol worship, they also do things which attract demonic angelic presences, and then many things happen in the atmosphere. But if you, the child of God, will read the scriptures or confess the word of God or worship or sing, you also release into the atmosphere. So when you release the goodness into the atmosphere, then the negative will come under the authority of the obedience of the good presence, of the angelic presence, or the Holy Spirit. So let us occupy our space. Because many at times, many Christians, if we don't pray, what do? We let evil take dominion. Not that evil have power, but whoever is occupying space is just obeying a spiritual principle. So if me and you choose to keep our mouth without worshiping, without thanking God in between, then that is what we do. So I just want us to open our Bibles to Ephesians chapter 6, which is a very common one. And I pray that God will give us wisdom and knowledge and understanding, because I'm just teaching in part, okay? So Ephesians chapter 6 verse 10 says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you will be able to stand against the wiles of the devil." Verse 12, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Therefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you will be able to withstand the evil days. And having done all to stand, stand therefore, having your loins girt with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherein you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayers and supplication in the Spirit, watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints." So we can see how powerful, how the Bible is war telling us, you know. So whether we like it or not, it's not all that the eye can see. Things are not just black and white the way we think that it is. They are always supernatural empowerment. And that is why there are so many religions. Because if somebody don't believe in Christ, in our human nature, we are inclined to know that we are spiritual beings. So there's a yearning. So somebody might not know Jesus, but then they go to worship something else to fulfill that spiritual power. But if you're a child of God who want to enter the kingdom of God, you want to be worshiping Jesus. Because by the power in the blood, we are sealed. Because if somebody worship the idols, or any principalities or powers or water spirits or powers of the sun, that is idol worship in God's eyes. God said we should worship him, not the created things. So anytime we worship that which God have created, we insult the Most High God, and it is idolatry. But me and you as a child of God, or if you haven't accepted Jesus and you are not born again, give your life to Jesus. Ask for forgiveness. Believe for his mercies, accept him. And you will be his child. And if you're a child of God, you want to be commanding the angels of God to work on your behalf, to work on behalf of the nations, to work on behalf of the neighborhood. For instance, if you are a mother, in the morning when I'm bringing my children to school, I take the chance to release the peace of God upon all the school children. The mothers who don't have cars, who are working, the caretakers, I say, God, I release peace upon them. Let your peace be upon the children in school. Let your peace be upon the traffic, that all the drivers that are driving will know that children are going to school. Let your peace be upon those who are going to work in the morning. Let your peace be in the environment. Let your peace be on the single mothers and single fathers. Let your peace be upon the marriages. Let your peace be upon the businesses in the neighborhood. Let your peace be upon the airports or anything that God leads you to pray for. In the evening, you could be praying for the peace of God. Those who are coming from work, pray over the highways, the motorways, early morning, you know, getting to the evening. So there are so many things we can pray for. And at times, just release the angelic presence. Just release the angels of peace in the atmosphere. Release, because anytime we release the peace of God, don't forget that any activity that is done for God, there's always an angelic presence. It's the same on the negative side as well. So we don't see them, but they are there. So when you are releasing the Holy Ghost, or you are worshiping, or quoting the scriptures, you are doing it the same way anyway. But to consciously also do it is nice. So let's release the angels of God also into the supermarket. These days our food are so polluted. We can release the angels of God early hours in the morning and say, "Lord, we send the angels of sanctification to sanctify the food in Asda." Or we plead the blood of Jesus upon the food in the shopping center. We release the host of angels to go into Afghanistan, to let there be peace, to help those who need help. You know, we release the angels of God to combat against the wicked forces that make people to be killed and mistreated. And the evil angelic presence that is using the people of Afghanistan to kill their own people. So, Lord, we release the spirit of love. We send the angels of love. We send the angels of goodness and mercy to influence this nation. So, there are so many ways we can look into it and release the wonderful angels. We have angels also that watch the environment. We can release the watchers of God to watch over the territory, to defend the territory. Like if you look at nations, the borders are protected by territorial powers. There are people watching the waters. If you cross onto the wrong side, there will be war. It's the same thing. All the principle that applies on earth is the same thing in the spiritual. So we have to learn to speak them out. We can release the angels upon our borders of our country. In my country, Ghana, I'm hearing lots of things going on, which is heartbreaking, because Ghana is a very peaceful nation. But I hear some things and my heart breaks. So what I do now, early in the morning, so at midnight when I wake up, I release the host of angels upon the borders of the country. And also I release the host of angels into the bushes, into the remote areas, that if there's any wickedness going on, the angels of God should intercept to arrest. We even release the angels of police, that the police will be assisted by angelic presence. And when their job is too hard, there will be angelic police who can even go and do the arrest and team up and work with them. So we shouldn't be too stiff in our normal daily activities and daily thinking. Let us incorporate the angels of God, and the Holy Ghost will give us understanding. This is a little bit I have to share. And as I've been praying, this is how things that have been coming through my mouth, and I just want to share. So if anybody don't agree, we can drop a comment. Or if you have any advice, you can add. We are learning, especially as intercessors. At times, God lead us unknowingly. Before you know, we are praying some prayers and we are asking, is this the will of God or is it not? But to me, I think it's the will of God, because I'll have ways where I'll be releasing the angels of peace, the angels of love, the angels of provision abundant, the angels of divine protection. When I see the ambulance personnel driving to the emergency scene, I say, Lord, I send angelic embankment. Let your angels go ahead of them. Let your presence be ahead of them, that whoever they have to go and save will not die. Let them know what to do. So simple things like that. So this is what I have to share with you today. And I'm going to come up with proper teachings about the activities of angels and what they can do and how they influence the nations. This is just a little bit of experience that I have. So it is I will not be able to give you much scriptures. But the scriptures that I can give you now, you can read Psalm 91 verse 11, Psalm 34 verse 7, Ephesians chapter 6 verse 10 to 18. And there are other things about angels in the Bible. We've got the worship angels. We've got the angels that watches the throne of God. We've got angels that deal with the waters, the land, the sea. So there are angels for many things. We've got the angels of goodness and mercy, resurrection and life. We've got the angels of joy, you know. So basically the fruit of the Spirit will also be attributed with angels. If you also, the fruit of sin will also be attributed with evil angels. And that is why we have to be careful what we are influenced by. If gossip is coming onto your tongue, we are giving the spirits of evil your tongue and they will use it. But when you decide not to gossip, you overcome. So that you use your mouth to speak good works, what do? You also release positive into the atmosphere. So I will leave it here today. If you are not born again, please get born again. Jesus is coming very soon. And satanic angelic activities have intensified. But the same way, the angelic activity also intensified. So we have a responsibility to play as Christians. Let us go out there, preach the gospel, speak to people, encourage people, intercede into our neighborhoods. Release angelic presence from the heavenly side or the positive side. Shalom, shalom, shalom.